Yes, good morning, Darwin. It is 6 a.m. and I hope you packed an umbrella because the wet season has well and truly kicked in. Stay with us throughout the day for all of your outdoor updates only on Ranger FM.
Doing the morning ritual, get up pretty early, a bit of a coffee, check the weather, now go out and have a look over the chopper and do a bit of a daily. My name is Seb Robinson. I've been flying choppers for about 8 years now. Owner of Arnhem Helicopters. 2 R44s. Growing up, I was always pretty interested and infatuated with helicopters. I won a boot throwing competition and won a ride in a helicopter when I was about 6, I think. And ever since then, I just knew that my future was going to be with helicopters. Team Sebby from Lucky South, how you going? Mate, just on the ground at Ducky, just want to get outbound to the east.
What's
the contact? Zulu, probably 44.
3 Zulu, 44.
Yep.
Yeah, no, thank you, it's cool when you're ready.
Thanks, mate, see ya.
Look at here, let me tell you something.
Yeah, so today I'm heading out with my mate Nick. He did a trip with me a couple of years ago, and yeah, we sort of hit it off and been friends ever since. He's a pretty good photographer and yeah, that's about it.
Ready to go, mate, hyped up. We're in safe hands today. Big man, knows what he's doing.
Get going, eh? Coming back from being away out bush, we've been pretty busy, obviously wet season, out collecting crocodile eggs. We sort of pulled up for a week, so always got to catch up with mates and, you know, just jump in the chopper and cruise out for a fish or see what's happening, go from swimmer to waterfall. Yeah, it's good.
There she is. How cool is that? A little raw power from that.
You can run on for a long time. Run on for a long time. Run on for a long time.
Yeah, I reckon the wet season is definitely probably the best time of the year to be flying around and looking at stuff. At the end of the wet now, when everything's just water's full and there's crocodiles, everything's just alive. Wet season is definitely crocodile season. They're on the move. More often than not, you'd be an early morning, crocodiles would be pushed out and a long way from any deep water, and you got Nick in the chopper, you can get a good photo. Yeah, growing up as a kid in Darwin was pretty good. Like, you got out and always in the bush doing fun stuff, fishing and stuff like that. And then obviously as I eventuated into helicopters and stuff, it just became a lot more easy.
Oh, mate, absolutely God's country out here, isn't it? Blowing my mind, the cattle, the horses. Mind blowing.
Get a couple of good shots there, mate.
Absolutely got some belters, mate. Big mob of horses just run across the flat. Especially when they're filled with water, you just get that spray.
Yeah, it's something special.
Oh. This looks pretty cool here, just flooding off that floodplain down into this little tributary.
Yeah. Have a look here, see if we can see any fish. Here we go.
Well, you got one?
Got a couple there. Right on that corner.
You got it spot to land here?
Well, that fish, yeah, right in the corner where the two channels fork in together.
Yep.
You ready? We're on here.
Well, mate, you called it from the air.
You see them barrows and that little bit of whitewash?
Can't
scare them.
I'm feeling good here.
Scare them.
Here's yours, mate.
Thank you.
Let's go.
I know, it's just a sense of freedom when you're in a helicopter. It's just, there's nothing like it. Mate, I've got a big fish here. First cast, and we're on. Great fish. lines just around his gills at the moment, so just trying to be steady with him. Just so you can land here on the edge of a floodplain in a little channel like this and pull in a big, beautiful barrel like this. Oh, how good, how good.
Look at that, mate.
Nick and I have been mates now for a couple of years, always a bit of banter going on in the chopper, trying to get him set up for the right photo, and who gets the bigger fish.
I can't believe you kept these, mate.
Mate, like, just because you didn't catch any. Oh, you like carrying my fish?
We throw the cast net out over these things and hook them up to a couple big trebles, mate.
You live in the territory for a reason, and that's because you love the wide open spaces, good fishing, good hunting, and things that you can't see anywhere else in the world, things that you can't see anywhere else in Australia. And that's what Sebby loves. That's what Sebby gets to see, like, almost on the daily. And he loves to share it with people. And as we all do, connect with people that share similar passions. And that's what we did. We crossed paths. You couldn't ask for a better pilot. Sebby just moves that machine like it's him, you know, like he's connected to it, just is at home inside that little bubble. Hearing Seb's personal story of being a kid and seeing those machines hover over him and take off and watching obviously grown men fly when you're a little boy, I think he knew from a very young age what he wanted to do, what he wanted to build a career around, and he's certainly excelling in the field that he's chosen. He's not a bloke you meet every day, you only meet a handful that connection with and that mateship with, and so grateful we crossed paths and he was recommended to me by a few mates and took him up on that recommendation. I'm sure, I know we're gonna have some bloody good trips in the future and we'll be mates for many years to come.
Yeah, obviously there's a lot of passion in it, like I love what I do, and yeah, like the old saying goes, if you do something you love, you never work a day of your life. So I won a boot throwing competition. Actually, it was just down the road here at a gymkhana, like a rodeo. I'm at the gym right now, aren't I?
You work with only the finest models, Joycey?
Oh, I'd try and be a bit more selective than this if I had a bit more time, but doesn't smile though. Bit of an issue.
The regular cowboy. Hang on, start again. Are you keen for a swim?
What?